Hey mamas, most of the time when you're breastfeeding, it takes some time for your period to return, and the timing in which it returns varies from woman to woman. But when it does, many moms wonder how their period will impact their breastfeeding journey. So in this video, we're talking about just that, breastfeeding on your period. I'm Bridget, and I'm a childbirth educator, birth doula, and a mama, and it's my goal to help empower as many parents as possible in their parenting journey. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe to this channel and then hit the little bell so you don't miss any future videos. It's recommended that your baby gets breast milk exclusively for the first 6 months of life, and then at least for a year and beyond if you want, along with solid foods. Now, during this time span, your period will likely return, and when it does, there is no reason to stop your breastfeeding journey. It does not spoil your milk or anything like that. For some women, their menstrual cycle will not noticeably impact breastfeeding. Some mamas, though, will notice a dip in their milk supply during ovulation, through their period, or at least for some time into their period. And the reason for this is because of fluctuation of hormones during this time. So especially for mamas who are exclusively providing breast milk for their babies and want to avoid a dip in their milk supply, according to the well-known and respected book, The Womanly Art of Breastfeeding, to combat this dip in milk supply, mamas can consume a daily dose of 500 to 1,000 milligrams of calcium and magnesium supplement from the middle of your cycle, which is typically around the time of ovulation, through the first 3 days of your period to minimize any drop in milk supply. You want to make sure that you're taking both calcium and magnesium, and I've linked a supplement down below, but you, of course, want to talk to your care provider before taking any kind of supplement. Now, it's definitely not crucial to take a supplement at all. Women's bodies and babies are so smart, and so if there's a dip in supply, you might notice your baby wanting to nurse more frequently or longer, which is really the best way to help encourage an increase in milk supply. Now, if you're pumping, you will have to be the one who makes that demand on your body, which means pumping a few extra minutes or including one or two extra pumping sessions to help boost your supply. A dip in your milk supply shouldn't last forever, though, and things should return to normal after your period. Now, during your period, especially when breastfeeding, think about all that your body is going through. It's ridding your uterus of that lining that helps support those early days if a baby was in your womb, and it's also sustaining a baby outside your womb through breast milk. So your body is really expending itself a lot, and it's so important for yourself and your baby as you're providing their nutrition to be fueling yourself too. Eating foods like salmon and eggs for their healthy fats, berries, even dark chocolate for their antioxidants and anti-inflammatory components, lots of water to flush out toxins your body might be holding onto, and just decreasing the bloat at the same time, while also helping keep your milk supply up, then eating oatmeal and other whole grain foods and staying away from processed foods that might sound good in the moment but long-term aren't great are all ways to fuel your body while it's expending a lot of energy and helping keep your milk supply up while on your period. You also might notice on your period tender nipples and breasts and cramping, which are both correlated to a drop in calcium levels in the blood around that time of ovulation into the first few days of your period. For lots of women, period cramps seem to get more intense with each subsequent birth. But if you are taking that calcium and magnesium supplement, it can help, and a little essential oil remedy that has really helped me personally is a blend of clary sage, peppermint, and lavender essential oil with coconut oil that I rub onto my abdomen. I just do 1 to 2 drops of each oil in about a teaspoon of coconut oil, and I've linked all of those things down below. The tender nipples and breasts are made more noticeable when you're breastfeeding or pumping because of all the stimulation, so using warm washcloths can make it feel better, and if you're pumping, putting coconut oil on the inside of the flange so there's less friction can also help a lot. And then just reminder yourself that the discomfort is short-lived and what you're providing your baby through your breast milk is so worth it. So that wraps up this short video about breastfeeding while on your period. Mamas, you are all so amazing. If you need more information on breastfeeding, make sure you check out the rest of this playlist linked right up here. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, mamas.